I'm so happy to see you after a long, long vacation. And I could hardly recognize you now. You look so wonderful and great. Welcome back. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you. Today we are celebrating the solemnity of the most holy body and blood of Christ. And it is also known as Solemnity of Corpus Christi. Corpus Christi Sunday allows us to focus on celebrating the real presence of Christ, body, blood, soul, and divinity. For the many times then that we fail to recognize the Lord, for the times we doubted on the real presence, we ask God to forgive us. I confess
to the Holy God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, and what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my own serious fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
To show show you that not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes from the mouth of the Lord. Do not forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert with its serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless ground, who brought forth water for you from the flinty rock and fed you in the desert with manna, of food unknown to your fathers, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lo, the angel's foot is given to the pilgrim who has striven. See the children's bread from heaven, which on dogs may not be spent. Truth, the ancient types fulfilled. Isaac bound, a victim willing. Paschal lamb, its lifeblood spilling. Manna to the Father sent. Very bread, good shepherd, tend us. Jesu, of your love, befriend us. You refresh us, you defend us. Your eternal goodness send us in the land of life to see. You, who all things can and know, who on earth such food bestow, grant us with your saints the lowest, where the heavenly feast you show, fellow heirs and guests to be. Amen. Alleluia.
Amen.
be bound in heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled amongst themselves, saying, How can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. My flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There are so many things we thank God for. We thank God we're able to come back to the public celebration of the Mass once again, celebrate together as one family in the church. Imagine almost 3 months, to be exact, 89 days since the suspension of the public celebration of the Mass. And here we are. If you are happy and grateful, can you give an amen clap to the Lord like this? Another! God is so good, and He is good all the time. I just remember somebody telling me, love is sweeter the second time around. So for me, I believe our coming back to church is more stronger, more authentic. And today we're celebrating Corpus Christi, the body and blood of Christ, that once again we will be able to receive the body and blood of our Lord sacramentally. You know, my dear friends, every day I've been thinking of you, I've been praying for you every day. And I missed you, even though you don't miss Father Lester. You've been seeing me in the video, but I don't see you. So long as you are missing the Lord, you're desiring to come back. It really breaks my heart every time people ask me, when can we get back to church again? When can I receive communion again? When John Paul II visited Lima, Peru, somebody from the crowd of 2 million people stepped forward and said, Holy Father, we are hungry, we are sick, we not work, our children die before their time. Yet we believe, Holy Father, we believe in the God of life, and we hunger for bread. The Pope replied, You tell me you hunger for bread. You tell me you hunger for God. I want this hunger for God to remain. I want your hunger for bread to be satisfied. In our long staying home, not able to come to church, not able to receive the body and blood of Christ. Have you experienced that deep hunger, that deep longing for the Lord, that you desire for God? I always being touched when I hear them singing Psalm 63, it says, God, you are my God. My soul is thirsty for you. A parishioner of ours mentioned to me that every time she prayed the apostolic communion, she cannot help but cry. It's so moving and powerful. My Jesus, I believe that you are the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually to my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself and pardon to you. Never permit me to separate it from you. Amen. We have been through difficult times, especially spiritually. I myself had a lot of doubts and a lot of questions during this time. But what made me stood and strong in my faith and my personal relationship with Christ is coming to church with empty people, empty pew, spending an hour before the Blessed Sacrament. And it's so powerful for me just to stay an hour with our Lord Jesus Christ. Our first reading tells us the instructions of Moses before the people of God crossed the Jordan and entered the Promised Land. The fear of Moses is that the people, once they get comfortable in this new land, will forget God on whom they depend. So he tells them, remember the long journey in the desert, especially remember the food with which God fed them, the manna. So the reading introduced the main purpose of our celebration, how, since the time of Jesus, God sustains his faithful followers with the flesh and blood of his Son, Jesus, the bread of life. In the sixth chapter of John's Gospel, many people were so horrified by the claims Jesus makes for the reality of the presence in the Eucharist that they stopped following him. For them, they say it's too much to understand and to accept what Jesus was telling them, that this is my body, eat it. This is my blood, drink it. So John links Jesus giving himself for the sake of God's kingdom and our redemption with the communion we share with him in every Mass. When we receive the risen Christ in communion, we do not say Amen, the symbol of his presence or a sign of his life. It is Christ who gives us himself so that we might be transformed into his image and likeness. As if Christ says to us at every Mass, here I am, broken and poured out of love for you. Take me, I am here. Do you remember your first communion? Who among you received first communion when you were a kid? Can you raise your hand? You remember you were so pretty in all the white and the veil, and it was great. You were so excited then. I hope that every time you come to Mass to receive the communion, you always have that excitement, that long desire to receive the Lord. Every time as if you were receiving Jesus for the first time. According to the latest research study, half of Catholics in the U.S. don't know the Catholic teaching about the Eucharist, about the real presence. And for those who come to church, 1 in 5 Catholics reject the transubstantiation. Transubstantiation is that the bread and the wine becoming truly the body and blood of Christ. The study also says that More of Catholics believe in purgatory than the real presence. And they say perhaps it's because the teaching of purgatory is so distinct and unique for Catholics. It's a Catholic teaching that other Protestants don't believe and don't teach. While Protestant teaches that the bread and wine are simply symbol, a sign. And many others will say, oh, it's a pretty symbol, it's just a sign. But for us, we have to believe. It's hard, but it's through the eyes of faith that we may be able to really believe and can be convinced that this is Jesus Himself who is giving Himself to us in communion. In medieval times, Catholics rarely received Holy Communion. And in the absence of communion, veneration of the Blessed Sacrament took on a great significance. Seeing the host was thought to impact an intent to impart an intense power, but in the last 100 years we have been encouraged to receive communion frequently. As Catholics, we believe that Jesus is really and personally present to us in the broken bread shared cup of the Eucharist. We say Amen when we receive into our hands the bread, the blessed, and the broken, the cup poured and shared. Amen or yes of becoming the same Christ, blessed, broken, poured out, and shared in love. Let me ask you, since your first communion, how many times have you received the Eucharist? Is it 100 times, 1,000 times, 1,000,000 times? And you're still standing in your faith. I do believe that you became more and more being transformed to the likeness of Christ. You are Christ. When you receive Jesus, you make Christ alive in your life. So continue to share that Christ to everyone, in your family, in your community, and in the whole world. Please stand. Together, we now profess our faith. I believe in one God. We bring our prayers and petitions to the Father.
For the universal church and the Eucharistic people, may the grace of God help us to be faithful communities, united in love of God and neighbor. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who exercise authority in the world, and all who have responsibility for caring for those unwilling and the unwanted. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing and reconciliation in our communities, may God's mercy help us to overcome the violence and hatred and build stronger bonds of solidarity among us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who face economic uncertainties, the unemployed, and all those who are experiencing difficulty in any way from the COVID-19 pandemic, may God graciously look upon their needs, bring them relief, and grant them hope and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Jan Wong and Jim Ikuzin, may they enter into the fullness of life foreshadowed here in the celebration of the Eucharist. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray silently now for our own intentions and those held deep within our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of abundant love, as we bring our needs before you, we give thanks for the Eucharist by which we are fed the bread of angels. We offer our prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God, above creation, your goodness we have this bread to offer you. For the dear Lord, we must ask that will become the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God, above creation, your goodness, we have this wine to offer you. For the divine work we manage, it will become as faithful to me.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray for sacrifice and yours to be acceptable to God, your Almighty Father. Grant your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in history, in the offerings we here present, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to
the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for at the Last Supper with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as unblemished lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect grace, nourishing your people by this sacred mystery, you make them holy, so that the human race, bounded by one world, may be united by one faith and united by one band of charity. And so we approach the table of this wonderful and wondrous sacrament, so that in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities before foreshadowed. Therefore, all the creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and with all the host of angels cry out without end, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. May glory, therefore, this gift we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, let it do fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and revealing his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are they called to the supper of the Lamb.
Let us pray. Throughout the Lord, we pray that you may delight for all eternity in that share in your divine life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious body of God, living away forever and ever.
Amen.
It has been a long tradition in the Catholic Church that during Corpus Christi, people
sacrament around the town in the streets. And for us, I would like to invite you to give the benediction and we possess the Blessed Sacrament, and we ask God for blessing and for protection. Please kneel. Can you be seated? On behalf of our Paris family, I would like to extend my condolences to Carol for the death of Jim. Carol, be assured of our prayers for Jim and pray for you to be stronger in your faith. And we cannot have you now, but be assured that we love you, we support you, we are our family. And please continue praying for Carol. She needs a lot of prayers. We also brought her her arms. So she needs a lot of prayer. And the other day, I was told that Jen Deegan was in the hospital, and I just heard today that she passed away early morning. So please pray for Jen Deegan. Walter, the husband, just passed away last year, and they've been active in our church before. So please pray for their souls.
Once again, I want to thank everyone for helping us out, keeping people safe, bringing them in and out of the church. As I mentioned, the ushers will empty the church from the rear first. We'll ask that you want to stop and visit if we're away from the opening so I can move people out. Thank you, Anne, for bringing the donation basket to the back. If you forgot, you're welcome to drop it in there. It's truly an honor to stand up here with Father and provide service for people that have such love for God, and you show it every Sunday. So thank you.
So I just want to let you know that those who cannot make it to Mass for now, they prefer to stay home. They can watch our video of McCloud Mass in the afternoon of Sunday. And I know, I just want personally to hug you, to shake your hands, but we cannot do that for now, so maybe you just make a sign language. Say, happy, see you, miss you. Please stand. For our visitors, welcome to St. Joseph. We are happy for joining us in our Mass today. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks.